Long ago, when MMOs were still young, nerds played a game of great and terrible power. But this World of Warcraft erupted into a flame war that threatened to destroy the entire internet, until a brave and powerful player locked the salt away, imprisoning it within the mystical Millennium Items. Now, over a decade later, a boy named Kripp unlocks the secret of the Millennium Puzzle. He is infused with ancient salty energies, for destiny has chosen him to defend the internet from the return of the Warcraft, just as the brave player did 10 years ago.
Hey guys, how's it going? Kripparrian here. Today, I want to tell you about Hearthstone. I've been playing for a while now, and I'd have to say I'm pretty good. It's a card game based on Blizzard's Warcraft series, and since I'm such a Blizzard fanboy, I just had to play it. So let me queue up an arena game and show you what it's all about. Really? Top deck Fireball? That guy had a perfect curve and insane answer after insane answer, and then he gets lethal off the top? Wow, coin knife juggler into mad bomber with perfect juggles and bombs? So pretty much we lost this game in the first two turns by losing 4 coin flips in a row. This guy's deck is unbelievable. How is he 0-2 with cards like that? This is seriously the best deck I've ever seen at no wins and 2 losses. He had Zombie Cho, Shielded Minibot, and Muster for Battle. How did he lose twice with a deck that can easily go 12 wins?
Wow, that guy is salty. Wait, almost as salty as me. Good thing I'm a renowned Hearthstone player and run a wealthy organization called Tapewurm, so I can prevent this guy from getting too popular on Twitch TV.
Hello? Grandpa Reno, are you home?
Ring, 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 ring. Bong, bong, bong.
Hey guys, how's it going? Kripparrian here.
Ah, Kripp, just the person I wanted to talk to.
Reynad?
I've kidnapped your Grandpa Reno.
You bastard! What have you done with him?
I'm holding him hostage at the Tempestorm headquarters so that you'll duel me.
What? Why?
Just get over here for plot's sake.
Grandpa Reno, are you okay?
Yes, Kripp, I'm fine. But here, take this.
Your deck? But why?
Because everyone knows you're just a salty arena scrub and sucker constructed. You're going to need a real deck to face Reynad.
Okay, I won't let you down.
That would be pretty hard to do since I'm not expecting much.
So you finally showed up. I hope that salt on your stream wasn't all just talk. Let's see if you can really play.
Playtime is over. Kripparrino!
Now, Reynad, prepare yourself, because it's time to duel.
Wait, did you just get taller?
I'll go first. I'll end my turn.
Job's done.
If that's the best you can do, you better give up now. I'll coin out Wild Growth.
Wow, a perfect start. I equip Fiery War Axe.
I'll use Farsight. Heh, perfect.
For my turn, I'll play Arcane Intellect.
What does that do?
It allows me to draw 2 cards from my deck.
Instructions unclear. I'm playing Summoning Portal.
Very well. I'll summon a gnomish inventor and attack your minion with my axe.
I hope you're ready to lose. I'll use Innervate, giving me 7 mana for the turn. And with Summoning Portal on the field, I can play Nefarian, which adds 2 random spells to my hand.
Really? You top decked a powerful minion and had Innervate?
Your move.
First, I'll kill your portal with my gnome, and attack your face with the last charge of my axe. Then I'll combo my Death Spite and Dread Corsair.
So you had a perfect tempo play too. Doesn't matter, as I summoned the Onyxia I drew with Farsight earlier.
Oh no!
That's right. You thought one dragon's bad? Well, here's 2. Oh, and she brought some friends. Now I'll crush your weak taunt with my Nefarian.
This isn't looking good. And I can't figure out what to do with these cards. They're just a bunch of pieces. How can I win?
Use the force, Kripp!
Grandpa Reno, is that you?
Trust your instincts!
Well, if that really is you, and not some hunger-induced hallucination from being a vegan, how about some real advice?
Sometimes the cards are like a puzzle. You have to put all the different pieces in the proper place.
How is that any more helpful?
Like the pieces of a puzzle.
Wait, Grandpa Reno once said,
Hearthstone contains only one unstoppable combo, but it can only be done by drawing all five special cards. A feat to this very day no one has ever accomplished.
Quit stalling with your flashback or you'll forfeit the match.
Just like I tell my viewers, I never concede. I have faith in my Grandpa Reno's deck and I can feel his strategy in these cards.
Another piece.
Now I'll finish off your Nefarian by attacking it with my gnome and weapon. Then I'll end my turn by playing Emperor Tharison, reducing the cost of all cards in my hand by one.
What a weak turn. I'll trade my five whelps into your emperor and crush your face with Onyxia. Finally, I'll play Ancient of Lore and use its draw effect. You see, luck is what this game's all about. It's about putting the most powerful cards in your deck and drawing them when you need to. Faith and strategy is for losers.
I'll play this slam I just drew on your Onyxia and draw one card. Just what I needed. Now I'll execute your dragon with this.
You lucky piece of shit. How did you top deck the one card you needed to not only injure my dragon, but also give you a chance at drawing the necessary removal and then actually draw the execute? God, you are just so good at this game.
Lastly, I'll summon an Acolyte of Pain and end my turn.
Whatever. I'll place this mage secret face down and summon a Chillwind Yeti. And then I smash your face with my Ancient of Lore, putting you down to just 9 life. Next turn, you're dead.
I still don't have the full combo yet. I need a way to stay alive for another turn. Ah, magic card. Frost Nova. It stops all monsters on the field for one turn.
Jesus Christ, are you serious? Well, one turn won't save you. And I just drew my third legendary dragon, Nazdormu. Now draw your last pathetic card so I can end this, Kripp.
My Grandpa Reno's deck has no pathetic cards, Reynad. But it does contain the unstoppable Grim Patron combo.
Impossible!
I've assembled all five special cards. All five pieces of the puzzle.
The Grim Patron? It's not possible! No one's ever been able to call him!
These cards, along with the whirlwind effect of my Death Spite, will bring my Frothing Berserker's attack up to 21. And that, along with some charging patrons, is more than enough to finish you off.
Not so fast. It seems you forgot about my Nazdormu's special ability. It allows me to limit the number of animations you can complete in a single turn.
Oh no!
That's right, you'll still lose.
Haha.
What's so funny?
You forgot the Blizzard hasn't done anything to prevent the fact that all of my ending animations can cut into your turn's time despite the number of complaints. And with only 15 seconds, you're not going to have much of a turn at all. I may not finish you this turn, but I will on the next one. Now go, my frothy berserker!
No, this can't be!
Now, I'll finish you with another attack from my Frothing Berserker. Game over.
Not quite. You've activated my ice block, which I got from Nefarian, and prevents you from killing me.
No way! Perfect RNG saved him? Fine. I'll trade my remaining patrons and minions into your dragon and Ancient of Lore to stay alive.
Heh. Guess I'm pretty skilled after all. Attack, my Yeti!
Did you really just top deck lethal?
Yep. Go Lava Burst!
No, it's all over!
On my Yeti.
Wait, he missed lethal?
Haha, actually I have Mortal Strike from Nefarian as well. I was just BMing you. Now say goodbye to your remaining life points!
Wow, never lucky. He needed exactly those two cards from Nefarian to beat me, and the chances of that were like 1 in 13,000.
Ben Brode, sir. It seems Reynad, the reigning King of Salt, has been out-tilted in a duel by someone named Kripp.
Draw your last pathetic card so I can end this, Yugi.
My grandpa's deck has no pathetic cards, Kaiba. But it does contain the unstoppable... Just-